Hello, I'm Mariell Jessup, immediate past president of the American Heart Association, and I'm here with our president, Elliott Antman. We're at Scientific Sessions in Chicago. Elliott, it's really exciting to be here. We've worked all year for lots of new ideas, new things. Please tell us, besides your presidential address, what trials are you looking forward to?
Well, Mariell, thank you. And first, let me say how fitting it is that we're here in Chicago. The AHA was founded here 90 years ago. It's just wonderful to reconvene here in Chicago. We have jam-packed late-breaking clinical trial sessions, lots of things that I think may impact not only our clinical practice, but our clinical practice guidelines. The ones I'm particularly interested in are the dual antiplatelet therapy trial, DAPT. That's going to examine how long we should give dual antiplatelet therapy after a coronary stent has been deployed. We have lots of patients who have hypercholesterolemia. The optimum management for them is not yet resolved. And the IMPROVE-IT trial is going to examine simvastatin versus simvastatin plus ezetimibe. There are lots of other interesting trials that I'm going to pay attention to. Biodegradable stents, should we be giving oxygen to patients having a myocardial infarction? How is our Mission Lifeline Systems of Care program working?
Your lecture for the presidential lecture, can you give us a hint as to what you're going to talk about?
We are all surrounded by big data, and it's engulfing us every day. So the title of my lecture is Saving and Improving Lives in the Information Age.
Great, I can't wait to hear it. In fact, our Global Congress is also on big data.
Yes, the Global Congress is dealing with big data because this is an important platform around the world. We could be using it to improve patient care. We could be using it to improve the way we do clinical research. And so attendees from all around the world are here in Chicago to discuss how we're going to use big data in cardiovascular medicine.
That's right. There's even a discussion about genomics and big data and electronic medical records and big data. So it's something that is really going to touch all of our lives, and we can't wait to hear about that.
Yes, you know, we could be looking at outcomes research with big data and mobile health technologies as well. I think this is going to change the way we practice medicine.
I think you're talking to the Vice President Cheney.
I think you are as well. Yes, and former Vice President Dick Cheney is actually an individual who has a history of heart failure and had a heart transplant. And we have a very interesting opportunity here at Scientific Sessions. He's coming to give us his perspective as a patient. And I know you are speaking with him in a session in Scientific Sessions, and I'll have the opportunity to interview Vice President Cheney along with his physician. It'll be very interesting to see how an individual who was right in the limelight and was in the public's eye actually dealt with that issue and how he's dealing with things as a patient with congestive heart failure who's had a heart transplant.
Please tell us about some of the other special lectures we're going to hear.
Yes, the Connor lecture this year, which will be at our opening session, is going to be by Dr. Donald Ingber. He's a very interesting individual who does bioengineering, and he's going to be talking about organs on a chip. I've asked Dr. Lars Valentin, who, as you know, has run a very large registry in Sweden, to talk about something that we all discuss, but he's actually done it, which is to actually embed randomization in an observational study. So that's a very interesting point. He'll be the Paul Dudley White International Lecturer. Bob Lefkowitz, our Nobel laureate, will be talking about the 7 transmembrane receptors. Our close colleague, Rob Califf, will be talking about using evidence to make our very best decisions for patient care.
Well, I'm really looking forward to the meeting. I hope you've polished off your speech because you're setting really the pace for an innovative meeting where there's many opportunities to network and bring home science that's going to change how we take care of patients and how we translate the science we're doing into better patient care.
Absolutely. And, you know, Mariell, the American Heart Association is always listening to individuals who are actually attending these meetings. And so you've asked, we've listened, we've delivered. Everything you need in the cardiovascular world is right here at Scientific Sessions in Chicago.